freshman year of Conard High School. So I would like to welcome you tonight to Conard High School's spring concert and senior celebration. I am honored to be here tonight. I feel grateful to be here tonight to share this time and share this moment with you while we celebrate and watch our wonderful students showcase their absolutely magnificent talent. Before we do that, however, I would love to take this time and I ask that you join me in a moment of silence to honor those fallen in Uvalde, Texas.
Hi everybody, my name is Evan Drake. I'm the orchestra director here at Conard High School. Welcome to the spring concert. Our first piece today is going to be conducted by our student teacher, Christina Sack, who's with us this year from UConn. And she's been with us all year long, and this is her very, very last act as student teacher is conducting this piece. We've been really, really grateful to Christina for all of her work. She's done an amazing job. She's going to be a first-grade teacher right out of the gate. And so congratulations, Christina, and thank you for being here. Enjoy the concert.
Thank you. quickly. So this woodwind and brass section is Crosstown. It's Hall and Conard, and they played like so many concerts this year for us, which requires a ton of extra time, schedule, like manipulating, and they've done it miraculously without a complaint, and they've done a fantastic job. It's so hard to play orchestral wind. It's so very, very different from playing with a section. Everybody has their own solo part. So I wanted to thank our wind and brass section for this year. They were great.
Thank you. Good evening and welcome back again. This is the choir portion now. We're going to begin with two songs from the Justice Choir songbook. These songs hit a little bit differently right now, so I urge you just listen to the words of this one. They are really, really something special. Watch out if you're in any of the aisles, because we'll be using them as well, so please clear all the zones for us to walk through. The first one is Lead With Love, featuring various soloists in your program. We'll follow that with We Walk In Love.
Thank you.
the very end of April each year, the choir department also puts on a giant Broadway concert. We're going to reprise one of our pieces from that and making sure that microphones get ready to go right now. And that's going to feature our three soloists as well from our Broadway concert. If you saw it on the actual day, this is an opportunity for us to redo that with everybody here pointed at you in true choir format. This is opening up the musical waitress. Elijah and Dominic on drum set and on bass for those three pieces. Much appreciated. Thank you so much. Microphones are now to new soloists. The following piece was part of the virtual choir things that Eric Whitaker released long before we even knew about what virtual choirs actually meant and the amount of work that went into it, we are pleased to present you not a virtual choir performance, but an actual performance of a choir performing Flight of Paradise by Eric Whitaker. The piece is going to feature two soloists, and we hope you enjoy this last one before we take a small break. The band come out, and we'll come back on for our scene recognition and our final piece of the program. So thank you again. This is Flight of Paradise by Eric Whitaker.
Hello, I am not Michael Wyatt. Michael Wyatt is absent for 5 days. We found out yesterday. So he's at home watching the live stream, eating chicken soup. We love him, Mr. Wyatt. We miss him. He's been a great addition to the Conard community, and we're really lucky to have him. So how about a round of a hand well wishes for Mr. Wyatt? I also have to compliment this band. This is a group of kids that, you know, we had COVID, and then Mr. Porter retired, and then we had Ms. Wattel for here, which was amazing. And Ms. Wattel left. We had Mr. Porter back, which was great, and then we found a new band director, and they've just been absolutely resilient throughout this whole process, and we're really grateful to you for sticking it out, right, and continuing to make music. We had a rehearsal yesterday. And they were like super cooperative, and just we're all working to make this work today. And so thanks, guys. Here we go.
Thank you. Thank you. All right. So as the rest of the seniors come out, shaking off what instruments they play, that was a joke. So this senior award for each ensemble is a really cool tradition that we have at both high schools. And basically what it is it's a student-voted award. So all the kids vote for their peers. And what they're voting for is the person that they feel is sort of like the leader of their group, right? So sometimes it's somebody who's the best player, sometimes it's not. This is not necessarily about the competitiveness of music. This is more about somebody who keeps the ensemble going and they have somebody that everybody sort of looks up to.
And they look up to them both in and outside of rehearsals, being somebody who's a constant proponent and supporter of their group or the other parts of the program that are not their group. It's really the people who are those people that bring up the entire program.
So, as Mr. Wyatt's not here, I'm going to give out the band awards first. So the recipient of the 2022 Senior Band Award number one is Katie Flaherty. And the other 2022 Senior Band Award recipient is Ethan Hardesty.
First recipient of the choir, which is going to be Elizabeth Tebow. Yeah. And the second recipient is Cameron Hoskins.
Awards. I have to say that this is a very special senior class. They're ridiculous in every way. There's a meme page, which is usually making fun of me. And so we're going to miss them very much. They've been a great group of kids. The first recipient of the 2022 Senior Orchestra Award is Lydia Griffin. The second recipient, you ever have a coach that you would just absolutely go to battle for no matter what? Somebody you would run through a wall for. Well, this recipient has inspired the orchestra with these amazing pregame speeches, and we're proud that he's the recipient of the Orchestra Award, Conard.
We would like to first just recognize what is up in front of us right now. These seniors persevered through an awful lot to be up on stage here tonight. This round of applause is for all of the seniors, no matter who they are, how many times they've been on the stage before. All of you, thank you for all of your time and commitment. And
was gotten most of us through these past few years of COVID and all that. I know me and my fellow Meme Page owners all agree that orchestra is our favorite class of the day. I will carry all of the countless tangents and memes with me as I move on to the next stage of my life. Thank you, Mr. Drake, and let me know if you ever catch the baton.
So, friends, Romans, these past 4 years have been very tumultuous, and even through the darkest depths of the tragedy and despair in the world, with a grueling pandemic, I have always been able to look forward to orchestra every single day. Just the lively social environment Mr. Drake has cultivated through his masterful personality. It's unrivaled. It's what makes this orchestra program truly special, and I am blessed to have taken part in it for all these years. Thank you.
Throughout all of our 4 years at choir, I've been with you through two choirs, three choirs, so many things, so many good times, so many pandemics. It's been such an honor to be led by you, to be taught by you. I have an illustrious TA, voices of the world, but that has taught me less than simply watching you be such an amazing teacher for all of the choirs. You inspire us with your endless energy. You come to every single rehearsal ready and telling us that we can be the best that we can be, and then you help us get there.
Stage and everybody else go to a place you need to be to perform.